Welcome students, as we talked about that now RNA of the virus has been entered into the cytoplasm of the host after the fusion of endosomal membrane with the viral membrane and the by the action of lysosomal enzymes. Now this viral DNA, now it is present inside the host cell. This viral DNA already has poly A tail and 5 prime cap. That is very important for the attachment. That this 5 prime cap is very important for the attachment of this RNA on the host cell ribosome. Now what will happen? This RNA will assemble itself on the ribosome for the production of protein. The first protein that will be produced by the translation of this whole RNA will be, the first protein that will be produced, it will be DNA dependent, sorry not DNA, it will be RNA dependent RNA polymerase. The first protein or enzyme that is going to produce from this translation process is RNA dependent RNA polymerase. Now this RNA dependent RNA polymerase is basically an enzyme, that is going to replicate the host RNA, the viral RNA that is present in our host cell. This is going to replicate, it's going to produce lots of number of copies of this viral RNA. So what will happen? For example, RNA-dependent RNA polymerase has been produced by the process of translation. Now, the viral RNA will be attacked by this enzyme. This RNA-dependent RNA polymerase will attack over this enzyme. It will move in 3 to 5 prime direction, and the RNA from 5 to 3 prime direction will be produced. Obviously, if this is 3 to 5 prime direction, then resultant RNA will be 5 to 3 prime direction. Again, this RNA dependent RNA polymerase will attach on this receptor, and another RNA will be formed that will be from 3 to 5 prime RNA. In this way, number of copies of RNA will be formed. Now, this RNA dependent RNA polymerase have one important property as well. And what is it? It can stop anyway. It's not necessary that this RNA dependent RNA polymerase will keep on moving till the end or till the terminal. What it will do, for example, this RNA dependent RNA, it will move over until this point and it will start stop further replication. So some small and very small RNA will also be formed, and it will be from 5 prime to 3 prime or 3 prime to 5 prime. Now we are having a number of copies of RNAs, viral RNAs in our host cell. Now what will happen? All these viral RNA, again they will be translated. What do I mean by translated? Again proteins will be produced from these viral RNA. So again on ribosomes, these RNA will be loaded and proteins. For example, these are the proteins that has been produced by the translation of these viral RNA. But there is a problem. These proteins are very large and they are not active protein. They have to cut into small active fragments, small active protein, and to convert these large inactive immature protein into small active fragments, active protein, an enzyme is required, that is protease. And this enzyme is present in our normal cells. They will help them to cut into active proteins, and now these active proteins and these RNA, they will again assemble to form a new coronavirus in our host cell. In this way, This is the coronavirus. This is, and these proteins will get them assembled, and RNA will be packed inside, and new coronaviruses are ready to infect other cell. They will diffuse out of the cell and they will infect other cell, or if the number of copies inside the cell, they may burst the cell and infect our normal healthy cell. Okay, in the next video, now we will talk about how different medicines can affect all the stages that we have discussed during the penetration of this coronavirus. To understand the exact mechanism of medicine that are being used by different countries, you need to remember three or four important things that I have discussed in this class. For example, glycosylated angiotensin 2 converting enzyme receptor. You have to remember that endosomes and lysosomes need acidic environment for the proper functioning. You have to remember that a protease is required for cutting the immature large fragments of protein into small active protein for their proper functioning and packing of RNA into them. Stay with me.